Hi, this is Wanda from Go Laser Go, and this is part two of our Creality Falcon 2 review, and in this review we're going to do some testing on a number of different materials to see how well it performs. I'll also be going through some of the other features of this machine that we didn't cover in the previous video. And you can hear our final thoughts on the Falcon 2 at the end of the video. So let's start by testing some MDF. Now I love using MDF as everything always seems to come out really well. I know it's not a long lasting material and it will fall apart if it gets wet, but I generally make fun novelty items, and if they disintegrate, well, we can just make some more. So I'm placing my MDF under the laser module, and in light burn I'm going to resize the image to fit the coaster, and I'll select fill since I want to engrave this. I'm going to set the speed at 6000 and the power at 25%, and I'm leaving the air assist unchecked as I tend not to use air assist when engraving. Now we click on the frame so that we can place the design in the right spot. At this point we were still getting the hang of centering the designs correctly, so it took us a lot of framing to get it right, and even then it wasn't quite spot on. Now this design comes from Creative Fabrica, and I'll put a link to it in the description field below, but you can see how great it came out. So since the engraving came out so well, we wanted to try cutting some MDF, and this nameplate is something I've been wanting to cut for a while now for my great-granddaughter's second birthday. Now we have used this pattern previously for Paula's niece, and we both think it's super cute, and the link to the Creative Fabrica file will be in the description field below. Now this is 3mm MDF, and we used a speed setting of 550 and a power setting of 100%. The Creality Falcon 2 cut out the design beautifully, and as you can see there's hardly any scorch marks. Her mother can paint the piece to suit Freya's room, or she can cover it in some pattern paper or some vinyl. We have a ton of these popsicle sticks, and we always like to test a few when we get a new machine. Now all we did here was type some text in Lightburn, and the font we used is American Typewriter. I just resized it to fit the popsicle stick and selected fill because I needed to engrave this. Now I like to use these in my garden, especially for my herb garden. They slip nicely into the soil and it helps me to keep track of what's growing where, especially when I'm starting a new planting area. Now you'll notice with the first one that we did that the text came out crooked, and this is because the air assist was on and it caused the popsicle stick to move. So for the second attempt we used some painter's tape to hold it down in place, and it worked much better. We always keep a roll of tape on hand for when we are engraving cardstock, popsicle sticks and any other lightweight item. It just helps to secure them in place. We wanted to engrave on some metal pieces, so for the first engraving we used a bottle opener that we found in a local $2 store. I've no idea what sort of metal it is, so we just went with the brushed stainless settings that are available on the Creality website. After we'd done it, we realised that we had selected the settings for the 40 watt machine instead of the 22 watt, so our mistake. If we had chosen the right settings, we would have definitely got a better result. It's not terrible, but I would have liked it a little more intense. Now we always like to test on some aluminium plates, so we downloaded a file from Love SVG. It's a free file, and there'll be a link in the description field below for that file. Now I always like working with aluminium. It's a bit like MDF. Everything seems to turn out great, as you can see here. Now we also wanted to try engraving a photo using the negative option in Lightburn. You can see the difference here with the negative option turned off and now with the negative option turned on. This was kind of a test, so we didn't really size it properly. Ultimately, we want to engrave the image so that it completely covers the aluminium plate. It came out okay, but I still think we need to do a little work on the settings for this. I like making greeting cards, junk journals, and working with other paper crafts, so I always like to test each of the engraving machines that we get with a few pieces of cardstock. Now I find that darker colours always work best, so I chose a navy blue for this first test, and we used a red for the second test. Now, I wanted to make a birthday card for my great-grandson who was into fishing, so we downloaded a file from Creative Fabrica, and I got Paula to edit the file to add his name. Now it came out great, as you can see here, but I didn't notice until later that she had spelled his name with an E instead of an O. So I will be doing this again, but this gives you an idea of what you can do. Now you'll notice we also cut around the shape because I wanted to create a 3D effect on his birthday card. So this is how it looked in the blue, and then we repeated it with the red, and I think the red came out a lot better. Now you'll see a bit of soot on the surface, but it wipes off easily with a dry cloth. We also cut around the fish design again, but this time we cut the inside pieces as well. Now this is a really nice effect, but it does take a bit of time to weed out all those little pieces. However, I know that paper crafters out there won't be fazed by that. It's all part of the creative process. Now the final result is worth it, I think, but as I said, I will be doing this again to get his name right. Next, we thought we might try some leather. Now we haven't had too much experience cutting leather in the past, but we had some scrap pieces that we thought we might try out. Now we did a few tests and finally found the settings that worked for this type of leather, which although it has a nice soft feel, it is quite thick. And by the way, all the settings we used for all of these materials, plus the files that we used, can be found on our website at golasergo.com, and we'll put a link to it in the description field below. Now, for this project, we used the same image that we used for the metal engraving that we did previously, but this time we added an outline so that it would cut around the image, and I think it turned out great. Now for our final test, we thought we'd engrave a slate coaster. Now we used a file from Creative Fabrica, and we went with a speed of 6000 and a power setting of 25%. I was really happy with how this turned out. Now slate always seems to engrave really well, so it's pretty hard to mess it up. Well, I have to say that this machine has a lot going for it, and there was a lot that we didn't get to in the first video, so let's take a look at those features now. Now we'll start with the safety features, and there are many. Firstly, the triple monitoring system monitors the status of the air assist, the lens, and also checks for flames. Now when you turn the machine on, you'll see that the three lights on the laser module light up, and these lights show different colours depending on the situation of your machine. So for example, if the air assist is not working, the air assist light will flash red. If it's orange, it means there's a moderate amount of air running through the pump, and if it's green, a large amount of air is running through the pump. And by the way, you can adjust the amount of air running through the pump by turning the dial on the side of the machine. The machine also has an automatic stop if the machine is tilted. In hindsight, we probably should have tilted it from the side to demonstrate this, but fortunately, the machine does what it is meant to, and it turned off before we had any issues. You also have the option to manually turn off the machine at any point by pressing down on the stop button. Now, this is a really handy option to have in an emergency. The key that turns the machine off and on is another nice safety feature. You don't have to use it, but if you have kids or a cat that might want to use your laser machine when you're not there, then you might want to lock it. So removing the key from the machine will stop them from turning it on. Another great feature is that you can use this machine offline. You just need to load a G-code file onto the TF card and insert it into the side of the machine. Then click the framing button to see where it will engrave or cut. You can also use the up or down arrows to nudge the laser module around the material, and you can click on the home button to home the machine. And one final feature that I love is the number of feet holes on this machine. There are three positions, and it's a great idea for those with a limited work area. This allows you to attach the feet in a position on the machine so that it sits nice and sturdy on your workspace. So what are our final thoughts? Well, this is an awesome machine with so many features. It has so much going for it, and I have to say, it's now become one of our favourite laser machines so far. And bear in mind that we have 10 of them at this stage. The fact that it comes pre-built is a huge plus. This makes it super fast to get up and running for a beginner, and it reduces the initial stress of trying to figure out how to build a machine. The air assist comes standard, which you don't always find in most machines. Usually you have to purchase it as an optional accessory. And the safety features and the use of indicator lights makes it easy to monitor your machine for any issues. Now Creality have done a great job with this machine, and we definitely recommend it. So, that's all I have to say about the machine. If you've enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for watching.